We're having a very good time right here, yes?
Hi.
We are.
So am I. I already feel so soothed just in the last day and a half, and I'm so, so happy to be here. My question is that really since the January workshop in San Diego, I've been so much more intensely focused on being in the vortex, and I've been in the vortex so much more of the time, and there's...
Is there a clown in your vortex? Is there a clown in your vortex?
That I keep looking at this thing that pulls me out of the vortex, so stop it. But I'm looking for some soothing on that.
Well, isn't it interesting that the soothing on anything that blows you out of the vortex is don't look at it?
Yes.
In other words...
That's why I started laughing.
Instead of
right
saying...
Right now I know that.
When you're in the vortex, the problem's non-existent. Isn't it interesting? When you're out of the vortex, someone must die. When you're in the vortex...
Have you been with me for the past month?
Yes. When you're in the vortex, then you find the humor in it, or the fun in it, or the clarity in it.
Yes.
So it makes all the conversations that we have about outside the vortex stuff sort of unnecessary and yesterday-ish.
Yes.
And it makes anything that we can think of that makes us feel good the subject of attention. So what makes you feel good? In other words, we're not talking to you. You already feel good. What makes you feel...
Sitting in this chair makes me feel good. Yes.
It's like... Think of the things, if you're ever outside the vortex, think of the things that have felt the best, and just pondering them will take you back into the vortex.
Yes.
In other words, watching the Super Bowl can be an in-the-vortex experience for 50% of the audience.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes. I think of Barack Obama, and I am not a political person, right in the vortex, and I actually, last night, I had this thought. I thought, because I love business so much, I thought maybe I could do for business what Barack Obama did for politics.
Yes, we hear your beeper.
Thank you.
Explore that thought further.
Well, I thought if I stay in alignment with business and I don't focus on the part that feels lackful to me, if I just focus on what I really, really love about it, people come to me and they ask me questions about business and they're inspired about me and I get asked to speak at these huge events and I've been on the cover of these business magazines and then people are like, they're drawn into what I'm doing, and when I do it in a way that's not pushing against anything, it flows so beautifully, and I love that.
And so what you're wanting to explain to them is that you and others like you are riding the wave of what has been asked for by the mass consciousness.
Right.
In other words, explain to them, as you do, that there are always those who thrive in the worst of times as there are those who suffer in the best of times.
Right.
And it's an individual choice. Yes. It's not a global event.
But then I have this big yeah, but that comes up because my business stuff has been like, psh, psh, millions lose millions, millions lose millions. And when I get in that space, I sometimes want to say, well, yeah, but you sort of don't really understand because I'm not really there. And that's what, I can feel it right now. It just tears me apart to even think that.
Well, the universe does not know the difference between the vibration that you're offering because you're in the vortex with what you want, or whether it is something that is in your actual reality, in the reality that is already manifested. The universe is responding to the vibration of your being. And so as you consistently are able to maintain the vibration of your being, the manifestation has to surround you that matches that, you see. And so reality doesn't mean diddly squat. It doesn't mean anything. What it is, it's the bouncing off place, and where you've bounced to is what really matters. So what's tripping you up a little bit? We can give this to you easily. And the common denominator that's the reason that you pop out of the vortex when you do is because you are... As you think about being a voice or a personality or a focal point that could very well be one of the major catalysts in the nation or even the world for this turning around and people coming out of it or even feeling better, is that you sometimes forget what you know and you try to see what they see.
Yes.
In other words, you're looking at yourself through their eyes.
Right.
Instead of through the eyes of Source in the vortex. So when you find yourself, this is another new place that you're leading us to that we have not been before. When you find yourself second-guessing yourself or yabating, without exception, you're out of the vortex. Mm-hmm. So stop and say in this moment, I'm going to cease my thought on this subject, because any thought I think while I'm out of the vortex on any subject, and especially the subjects that I care about, is counterproductive. So it's sort of like if you can't say something nice, should we sing it? Don't say anything at all.
Yeah.
You are like so many people, you're used to trying to think your way out of a situation.
Right.
And you can't get there from there.
Yeah. Yeah.
So the new way of looking at it is, I'm not going to try to think my way out of the situation. All my thinking's going to be, I'm going to think my way into the vortex, no matter what it takes. I'm going to change the subject as often as I have to. I'm going to think my way into the vortex. And when I get in the vortex, I'll have full view and synchronicity of everything that I've put in the vortex. Mm. And isn't it wonderful? Remind yourself when you're out of the vortex.
Yeah.
Did any of the stuff get in the vortex while you were in the vortex? This is worth talking about.
Mm.
Or did you put it in the vortex when you weren't in the vortex?
Yes, I did. The other day, my friend said that to me, and I said, my vortex was damn big enough before this happened. But I did. I did not want as big of a life as I
have before. Well, we're glad that you don't take it well. We're glad that you don't take it well when you're not in the vortex. That's a really good thing.
Yeah.
You will never ever feel good when you're not being all that you've become. And life is causing such fast expansion within you that sometimes it just takes your breath away. And the support that you're accustomed to, this is another thing where you're taking us to another new place where we're going to say something that we've not said before with such clarity. And that is, most physical humans are accustomed to or requesting or wanting support from other physical beings. And we want you to release all interest in support from other humans and get 100% of your support from the vortex. It's the fastest way that you will get into the place where you don't give a rip what they think. And if you don't give a rip what they think, then what they think, or what you think they think, it's usually not even what they're thinking, it's what you think they're thinking.
Right. It's what I'm thinking that's way more critical. They're thinking, you're amazing. And I'm like, well, I'm not really that amazing. Let me tell you this bad thing that I did.
Yeah. Well, stop it.
Thank you.
And when you're in the vortex, in other words, this is the thing. Let's leave this gathering with these words. When I'm in the vortex, no matter what went wrong is humorous to me, and I maintain my balance. When I'm not in the vortex, no matter how slight the situation, it gets way more of my attention than it deserves. Nothing matters more than me being in the vortex, and there is nothing over which I have greater control than my relationship with the vortex. Very good.
I love you so much. Thank you
good,
so much.
Good time for a segment of lunch.